Good morning, students. Let's begin chapter 6. Today's topic is increasing and decreasing functions. In this section, students, we will use differentiation to find out whether a function is increasing, decreasing or none. Okay, so first of all, let's see a function y is equal to x square. Here y means fx, okay, x square. Then graph of this function, it's x axis, y axis, origin, okay, and here it's 1, 2, -1, -2. It's the equation of parabola, okay, symmetric on y axis. So graph will be like this, okay. And now we will find, according to graph, that this function is increasing or decreasing and in which interval it is decreasing or increasing. Okay, so first of all, we are taking the graph right to the origin, okay, here, right to origin. See the values. Here I am writing the value of x and then it is fx, okay. If x 0, then fx also 0, okay. Suppose we are taking x 1 by 2, then fx is 1 by 4, x is 1, fx is 1, 1 is square. If it is 2, then fx would be 4, okay. Since here fx is equal to x square, fx means y axis. Okay, students. Now, students, observe the graph. Only right to the origin. Okay. Only the this part. Okay. Like this. When we move from left to right. Okay. See that height of the graph is continuously increasing. Okay. Height of the graph is increasing. It means fx is increasing for x greater than 0. Okay, I am talking about only this half part of this graph. Okay, right to the origin. Now, left to the origin. First, take some values, okay, x and here fx. Let x is -1/2, okay, then fx 1/4. If you are taking x is -3/2, it would be 9/4. If x is 0, fx is also 0. You can take more values, -2, then it is 4. Okay. And now consider the graph left to the origin. But when we move from left to right, okay, left to right, see that this graph is decreasing. So function is decreasing for x less than 0. Okay. Since height of the curve is continuously decreasing. Okay, now come to the point of definition of increasing function and decreasing function. Let fx is define on interval I. Okay, then first point, if x1 less than x2, that implies fx1 less than fx2. It means function is strictly increasing. Okay, in the given interval where x1, x2 belongs to I here it is interval. Okay, and for the strictly increasing, you can use the symbol of this. Okay, second, if x1 less than x2, that implies fx1 less than equal to fx2. Okay, then fx is increasing function. Okay, for all x1, x2 belongs to I. Third, if x1 less than x2, that implies fx1 is greater than fx2. Okay, then fx is strictly decreasing. Okay, for x1, x2 belongs to I. Next, if x1 less than x2 but fx1 greater than equal to fx2, then fx is decreasing. Okay, for x1, x2 belongs to I. For the decreasing, you can use the symbol this, downward arrow. Okay, students. So, first, these points keep in your mind to find the nature of a function. Okay, and now I am going to explain some point which we will use to solve the questions. Okay. Let f be a continuous function on AB, close interval, and differentiable on open interval AB. Then first, f is increasing if f dash x greater than 0. Okay, for all x belongs to AB. Second, f is decreasing if f dash x less than 0 for all x belongs to AB. Third, f is constant if f dash x is equal to 0. Okay, for x belongs to AB. Okay, and now solve the question of exercise.